averaging 20 points or more. Rodney Hood is his helper, and it's quite a compliment.
Absolutely. Look at Rodney Hood, 72% from the field. They don't force their offense. They play well off of each other. And if it's a live ball turnover, they're off in transition.
And on the other side for Vermont, they are as good as Kandon Roosen is. He's a key player for them.
Absolutely. Look at that, the tail of the tape. You see that when he scores in double figures, they've been undefeated. Right now on the season, he's only shot 38%. But for Catamount fans, he hasn't missed in warm-ups.
This is an experienced Vermont team. Point guard Sandor Carissimo makes his 90th consecutive start. Brian Volkel makes his 107th consecutive start. And then there's Duke, and what else can you say about the number six team in the nation? Off to a great start, 4-1, the lone loss to Kansas. Quinn Cook runs the point for the Blue Devils. And Rashid Suleiman gets a start at the two guard. Crazies are back in town, and just in time for another sellout here at Cameron Indoor Stadium, 360th consecutive.
Both coaches were saying, and the coaching staff saying, they want to start early. They don't want to play from behind. They want to get a lead and try to control the pace of this game.
Parker from the baseline. Beautiful touch. Expect plenty of that. He averages 22 a game, second best in the ACC.
If he's a baseball player, he's almost in a batter's swing right now. The rim is so wide, playing with tremendous confidence early in his young career.
Duke will extend its man defense, a shot clock getting to single digits for Vermont. Man wide open underneath, and after the pump fake, Clancy Rugg gets his first bucket.
If you're patient and you can turn the basketball over on the Duke defense and make them scramble, you can get points at the basket because they don't have shot blocking outside of Jabari Parker.
Parker had a career-high 6 blocks in Tuesday's win against East Carolina. Rodney Hood's coming off a career-high 30, but left it short. Vermont's a team that's kind of changing its style of play a little bit. They want to get up and down this year. Best known as a defensive-minded team the last couple, and Roosen leaves it behind. Cook wants a three, instead it's Parker to find him. Suleiman turns it over.
That's where Vermont wants to move the basketball around, and they've got to make shots. Remember, they haven't been shooting the ball well, especially from the three-point line, under 30%.
Coming off a loss Thursday at Wagner, where Vermont went 0 for 12 from deep. Parker seemingly is unstoppable. He's shooting 65% from deep. He's got all 5 early for Duke.
It's amazing how you can struggle for offense on one end of the floor, but your opponent is knocking down shots at over 60%.
Volkel does everything but score for Vermont as he finds Apfeld. That's the first assist for Volkel, who averages 6 a game to go with 10 boards.
This is where Duke is different this season. Rodney Hood taking shots from the perimeter. He can make it. He's one of the hottest shooters in the country. Last year with Plumlee, they were an inside-dominated team. Now this year, they get most of their points from the perimeter.
12th in the nation at 93 points a game for Duke. Vermont allowed only 59 points a game last season, and a great dash to the rim by Sandor Carissimo, 4-year starter at point guard.
You actually called the last game in East Carolina, and East Carolina was able to get inside and get penetration, and that's what the Catamounts want to do in this game, get inside the paint and try to get shots at the rim.
You have to be able to find that release against the Duke pressure, don't you?
Well,
whether that's on the bounce or back cut or where it might be.
Second or third option, because Duke cuts off that first shot penetration. But the patience right here, recognizing that gap right there. And because now the rule changes, you can't chuck the cutters. If you're beat, that's going to be a foul if you touch them.
Parker left it short. Hairston just into the game is on the glass, and that's a great sign for Mike Krzyzewski. You asked him what he was most curious about his team, and he said, I'm curious if we can rebound.
Yeah, that's the strength of it. Veteran coach, Hall of Fame coach. We ask him about curiosity.
all-time winningest coach in NCAA history. And they've been in the top 10 for 114 consecutive polls as Josh Hairston rolls in the first of two. Andre Dawkins also checked in a moment ago for Duke.
Well, that's one player that they're happy about. Andre Dawkins getting back, getting his feet wet. He's been off to a fascinating start. 8 points coming off the bench for him.
Carissimo, a senior from Sleepy Hollow, New York, gives it up and gets it right back. Locale has it stripped by Parker, and then the wherewithal to throw it off the freshman's knees and get it back. Brian Locale is a senior starter who does so many little things for Vermont. Even though he only scores 5 points a game, he's the linchpin to their squad.
Well, a play like that where Jabari Parker tips the ball away, that's going against a player you haven't played against yet and recognizing how quick he is, adjusting to how quick he is.
Quinn Cook commits his first personal. Head coach John Becker, most wins in school history for a head coach in his first two seasons, 46 and 28. Pardon me, that was Josh Hairston who got whistled for the foul. They say not Cook.
Got an attack going north to south. It's Duke's favorite. There you go. You got to go north to south because right now, if you're out there by the three-point line, that favors Duke. But good job of scoring on a broken play.
Vermont with the lead off of that bucket. Hood with the answer as he went to his right, and that's a rarity. Vermont turns it over. Atfeld lost it.
The challenge when you play against Duke, they're not the biggest team, and if you can get it inside, good things can happen. But you kind of come back down and defend because you got scoring in five positions, especially with Harrison. If you get it to him 5 feet from the basket, he can score the layup or get fouled.
Parker sizes it up from the corner. And a foul inside will be on the point guard, Carissimo, trying to block out underneath. Vermont knows a little something about upsets, and here early on, they're hanging Taylor Coppenrath on that season, and TJ Sorrentine, who's now the associate head coach at Brown. And one of the great things about the Vermont program, as Dawkins gets fouled, that's a second on Carissimo, is Coppenrath, who's still playing overseas now, 10th year in Spain. Coppenrath, a Vermont native, is still around the program. He's there in the summer. He spoke at Coach John Becker's camp over the course of the summer. So to have kind of a local legend like that still involved in the program is a tremendous boost.
Absolutely. Talks about the history. It helps recruiting. And that's a good time in their history.
Andre Dawkins makes it a three-point play after Carissimo picked up his second, and that's a key for Vermont. So Josh Elbaum, senior from Melville, New York, is now on the floor to run the point.
Vermont has to continue to attack. You can't go side to side. Get inside, see if you can get a high percentage shot or get to the free throw line.
Good look from Vocal. The turnaround is short, and it's ripped down by Dawkins. Cook will reset. He had a tremendous first half against East Carolina. Was off the mark in many ways in the second half against the Pirates. ECU nearly pulled off the upset. Dawkins steps into a three. And it's pulled down on the long kick by Hood. Dawkins again. And they'll give him a bump from Candon Roussin. It's his first. Roussin is a Marist transfer heading to Burlington, Vermont. Of course, people in North Carolina know the nickname Western Carolina, the only other Catamount mascot in Division I basketball. The 10-20-win season in the last 12 last season, and the success in New England, the only Division I program with 20 wins in each of the last five seasons. They were picked to win the America East.
So far at the first break, Vermont's still attached to this game. Dawkins is coming, giving them a wonderful spark. And it's good to see he getting his offense now. He's a national champion, so he's got experience. And I look at him in warm-ups. I like the calm and presence that he has for his teammates.
Rebound by Vocal as Dawkins misses from the free throw line for the first time.
Got to look to attack. That's the scoring position.
Hood gets whistled for the foul, his first. On the drive by Clancy Rugg. And so Rugg to the free throw line. Something he does well that may be lost in the postgame box score. He draws 9.2 fouls per 40 minutes. It's top 20 in the nation in terms of getting to the rim and getting other guys in foul trouble.
Well, he's hard to guard for big guys because he can step outside. You saw him. He was going on the right shoulder, took it to the basket, get to the free throw line, and he shoots 78%. So you want your best free throw shooters at the free throw line.
It's a Vermont team shooting less than 40% on the season. They have really struggled to take the lid off. Suleiman harassed, kicks, Dawkins an extra pass for Hood. Got it.
Simple basketball, extra pass. You passed up a good shot for a great shot, and Hood was able to knock it down.
And a three on the other side is good. Fresh off the bench, Kurt Steidel with his first triple.
How smart is Coach K where he says, you know what, playing against Duke, the lid opens up.
Dawkins this time, he's got seven.
Looking to be a shootout. If Vermont can get a good percentage shot.
Davidson thought the same thing. They had a great first half. They got the doors blown out in the opener here. Duke put a buck 11 on.
Yeah, well, because you got scoring in four positions at almost all times for Duke.
Shot clock at 7. Plenty of time. Perhaps a rush three that time from Steidel.
Get to him quickly. He's feeling it.
Just short. And a foul inside will go against Vermont. Pardon me, that goes against Emil Jefferson. Here's a look at the EA Sports Maui Invitational bracket getting underway Monday. And what a great tournament we have for you. Three teams in the top 20, including that new team in the ACC, Syracuse. Jimmy Boeheim takes a top 10 team to Maui.
Keep an eye on Gonzaga. Sam Dower Jr. came into his senior year in shape. He's having a great year. Good patience by Vermont to try to get the shot that they want.
Harold got turned around. Drew the foul on Dawkins. It's the first on Andre Dawkins. Hector Harold is a junior from Pasadena, California. Played 2 years at Pepperdine. And you ask, well, how does a guy, pardon me, Vocal at the free throw line, how does a guy go from Pepperdine to Burlington, Vermont? They've got a bunch of prep school guys on their team, and Harold played at Northfield Mount Hermon. Right in Vermont's backyard as Appfeld returns, and another one for Vocal.
Well, Vocal's shooting 50% from the line. You don't want to go in scoring droughts, especially when you're on the road playing at Duke.
We saw that last year, a really good postseason team. Florida Gulf Coast, the victim of a 30-0 Duke run.
We called that one, said, look, they're going to be a pretty good team, and I think Vermont's going to be a solid team.
Vocal has the takeaway for Vermont as he tried to go back door and now run on the floor. Circus shot left short. It will be Duke basketball.
Both offenses are getting what they want. Duke is getting what they want off the dribble drive penetration. Dawkins has come in and lit it up from outside. But also, Vermont is getting what they want. They've just got to make their shots.
Tyler Thornton frees himself for a little runner. Parker the follow slam!
He's a home run hitter. He can make the big play and enliven his teammates.
There's the first on Quinn Cook. This is not the first nor the last highlight you'll see from Jabari Parker.
Following up with the flow, freshman phenom off to a wonderful start.
Two-time Mr. Basketball in the state of Illinois. Think of all the great players who have prepped in Illinois. You're talking about Derrick Rose, D. Brown, Darius Miles, Kevin Garnett, Deion Thomas, Marcus Liberty, Nick Anderson, John Shire, who's now on Coach K's staff.
Anthony Davis.
Anthony Davis. He's the only guy to win it 2 years in a row. And he took Simeon to three consecutive state titles. Shire, part of that Chicago connection, of course. Coach K is from Chicago. And every trip back home that he took to recruit Jabari Parker has paid off already.
Jabari loses himself in the game. Coach Wojciechowski said he has fully unpacked his bags and he's enjoying being a college kid on a college campus.
Chose Duke over Michigan State and Florida. Foul inside will be on Parker. Pardon me, that's on Tyler Thornton. It's a second on Thornton. There's Wojo, one of Mike Krzyzewski's key assistants. Chris Collins, now the head man at Northwestern.
Says Wojo's going to be a wonderful head coach when he gets his opportunity, and he wants his assistant coaches to aspire to be head coaches.
And I love that discussion that we had with Coach Krzyzewski before the game today. The reason you see Jeff Capel won more than 70% of his games as a head coach, Nate James, and on down the line, because we don't really compartmentalize with our staff. Yeah. Everybody's involved in every decision. And as a head coach, that's kind of how you have to think. So he wants his guys thinking that way.
Well, I think that his coaching tree is going to make a run at it this year. Johnny Dawkins, I'm expecting big things for him at Stanford. Of course, Tommy Amaker with Harvard. Seems like they're going to win their league at the rate that they're going. So and then Northwestern is looking to break that NCAA drought.
Never been have the Wildcats of Northwestern. At Feld with the bucket inside, making it a 7-point game.
Vermont's done a good job of weathering the runs of Duke so far. Duke's got another run in them, but you've got to answer those runs and come back and score yourself and get rebounds on the missed shot. Don't give them second chance opportunities.
So you're saying it's not necessarily on the defensive end where you're going to stop the run. It's being able to answer on the offensive end.
Well, you got to play a complete game with them because, again, we talked about the scoring ability of Duke. They score easily, but also you've got to make them pay. This is a team that hasn't shot the ball well yet, but they're expecting for that lid to open up.
And it really has for Vermont, if you consider their numbers coming in. That was an air ball from Atfeld. Vermont shot just 39% in their loss to Wagner last time out. Hood, a triple for Rodney Hood. The Mississippi State transfer has 8 here in the first 10 minutes. And it's a timeout for Vermont, largest lead of the game for Duke, up by 10.
Watching the ball movement, extra pass. And Cook coming out, when he's shooting a three-pointer, he's really tough to guard. And then Hood, how about him? He's been lights out all season long, shooting a three-point shot. Very impressive, 72% from the three-point line.
It would be tough for Quinn Cook to duplicate the first half that he had against East Carolina. 11 points on 50% shooting, 7 assists and just 1 turnover. But really, the on-floor leader of this team fell off the cliff in the second half, only at 3 points, 1 of 7 shooting, and your DeMatha guy made some questionable decisions, I thought, in the open floor.
Oh, rose-colored glasses, baby. Rose-colored glasses. We can do no wrong. That 1 for 7 is a typo. But he's the emotional leader for him. So as they go, he goes. And both teams have said he's the X factor for him. He is a galvanizing young man. He plays with a lot of energy, and he can't get inside himself and lose the feel of the game.
Vermont going a little up-tempo here as Carissimo hits the floater. He's got 4. Duke had an 18-point lead against East Carolina, had that frittered away. The Pirates nearly pulled the upset and brought it to 1.
Yeah, because of dribble penetration, they were able to break down their matchup one-on-one from the perimeter.
Good defense inside, but Hood still converts. He's into double figures.
I'm going to take you back. Rodney Hood reminds me of Calvert Chaney. And Calvert Chaney was only a first-round draft pick by the Washington Bullets back then and the all-time leading scorer in the Big Ten. So that's high praises. He was hard to guard for Indiana.
Is it his versatility that impresses you?
Left-handed, same body type, same demeanor. It's got a burst to get separation. So he can score from the three-point line and mid-range game a lot like Calvert Chaney.
Shot clock at 5. Step back in a hurry. That's the second time the crazies have impacted a rush shot from Vermont. Cook changes speeds. Finds Hairston inside.
Vermont has to get a score right here. You don't want to play an uphill game.
Trying to work it inside, and Vermont's able to draw the foul on Hairston, his second.
Offensively, it won't be a problem for Duke. See the outlet pass, dribble penetration, and then Hairston, he's effective right down low, and then the Cameron Frazers are getting into it.
Four assists in the first half for Cook. He leads the ACC with 7 a game.
Because again, college basketball is almost a 100-year history. Cook reminds me of Michael Adams from Boston College. Got that perky-jerky game. Michael Adams scored better than Cook, but both of them controlled the game. Both of them very quick. And again, Quinn Cook is their emotional leader for Duke.
Alex Murphy on the floor for Duke. Hector Herold enters for Vermont. As Appel takes a seat. Does it make it tough to guard as Vermont goes zone here when a point guard is able to change his speed?
Well, remember Coach Becker said, we want to keep them off guard. So this is the first time they've gone to the zone. You've got the elevation by Hood. He scored on it, but you want to change up the tempo. You want to get your defense packed in to get rebounds if there's a missed shot so that you can get out and get good offense. High screen and roll. This is new to Vermont. They want to open up the offense.
Vocal, a rare shot. He's only averaging 5 points a game. Even though he's led the team in assists and rebounds every year he's been on campus.
He's so strong. He can get anywhere he wants. You got to elevate. When you're 5 feet from the basket, you got to knock that one down.
Cook probes, finds space, finds Dawkins. Another 3 and another assist for Quinn Cook.
Dawkins' feet were set, and his stroke is so pure. No wasted motion.
Beautiful look inside. First bucket for Hector Herold. And now can Vermont get in Duke's way? The Blue Devils have hit 7 of their last 8 field goal attempts.
Well, this is a high-scoring game right now. 36 points. You still have 7 minutes left in this quarter. Even for Vermont, they're headed towards over 30 points themselves in the first half.
Murphy couldn't follow it up, and falling away, he gets the foul. He may be shooting free throws when we return. It's Duke by 11 in a high-scoring affair early in Durham. Which is, yeah, there's a lot more points being scored, more trips to the free throw line, more free throw attempts, more fouls per game. There's still a little bit of uneasiness from the sense of the coaches, though, as Murphy has another free throw coming his way, in the sense that they're still kind of waiting to see how it plays out. And the officials you see during non-conference play aren't likely going to be the same guys that you see once you get into your conference routine. Vermont may not see these 3 again, so will it be consistent?
Yeah, absolutely. And Coach Becker was saying it's hurt his team so far because they're known for defense. They like to get into you. They like to bump cutters. But overall, and I was an offensive player, I think it displays skill. So you don't want the ticky-tack fouls. If there's not an unfair advantage, let them play. But I like how they're opening up the game, and it makes you display skill, which I like.
Rugg close enough to throw it home. As you're speaking about that, Wagner on Thursday night closed on a 10-4 run. 9 of those 10 points came from the free throw line as Wagner's able to hold on against Vermont.
representing the Catamounts to a 1-4 start on the season.
Yeah, I don't want the letter of the law. You want basketball balls organic. You got to let these people play. It's so quick and reactionary. Let them play.
Dawkins will go to the free throw line to shoot three after the foul from Rusin. Here's the difference for Duke. And think about all the great weapons they had on the floor last year with a four who could shoot the three in Kelly Plumlee, a presence inside. Their scoring's up to 93 a game. They're making more free throws. They're getting to the line more. So everything's up for Duke.
Well, Tom, you look at the efficiency. Jabari Parker and Rodney Hood from the three-point line, they're shooting no less than 65%. Are you kidding me? 65% from the three-point line? Most people are not shooting that from the free throw line. So when you've got your best scores shooting with an efficiency, the numbers are going to go up. The assist-to-turnover ratio is fantastic, too, 17-9. So they're efficient in their offense.
There is nothing more efficient than scoring points when the clock is stopped, and Andre Dawkins has another free throw coming his way. He already has 12 points today. And he is perfect from the free throw line. This Duke team is second in the nation in effective field goal percentage if you add in extra points for their shooting from behind the three-point line. It shows you just how good Duke has been through the first five.
The one positive about Vermont, they're patient on the offensive end and make the extra pass. That was textbook. They went side to side. Three people touched the ball, and then you get a cutter going to the basket. That was textbook. Very good execution.
Five for Steidel. Duke will pull it out. Let's see where they go here with Hood and Dawkins on the floor as the two main scoring options. Jimmy Ogilvie fires a three. He is not shy. His first field goal is buried, and the freshman's in on the board.
Well, he's shooting, averaging 3 points, but he's shooting 50% from the three-point line. That's his shot. He's getting comfortable early in his career.
Nice feed. And Ruggs into double figures with 10.
Right now, nobody's guarding anybody, which is good for us because it's in some offense. But Coach K will look at this and say they're scoring too easy on you. Easy basket, shot at the basket. Got a matchup zone from Vermont.
Dawkins in the corner. Wanted the foul, didn't get it. Volkel open floor, no look. And the reverse is swatted away by Dawkins. They'll count it off the rim. And that's the second field goal for Hector Herald.
We mentioned earlier that both offenses are getting what they want. Vermont has senior leadership. They got four players that are injured. But this is a team mentally that comes in and thinks that they can be effective. They're not intimidated by the moment.
Still without Gray Wills, who's nursing a broken finger. Ethan O'Day is injured. So is Ryan Pearson, a couple of their key bigs. Our Vermont team picked to win the America East. Rodney Hood has another triple. He has 15 now, coming off a career-high 30.
If I'm a scout, I'm watching how many open shots Duke gets, and it's a reason for it. Rashad Suleiman, who really hadn't gotten going this early in this season, has to be guarded. Jabari Parker has to be guarded, and that's how you're getting Dawkins with open looks. Rodney Hood with open looks. Can't cut off everything.
Turnover for Vermont, only their third of the first half. They find themselves trailing 47-33. Who do you choose to stop? Seems Duke always has an answer. That time it was Rodney Hood. I believe his coach may agree with me. He will be considered as one of the best players in the nation. Forget about class.
Yeah, Jabari is Jabad. He can play. Yes, he feels it. But the open look at this. There's one open look right there from Cook. Watch this again. Another open look. We're going somewhere with this one. And then watch the dribble penetration and another open look. Tom, you might say, how are they getting open looks against a solid defense? Because you can't cut off everything. They've got scoring from multiple positions. The extra pass will get you an open look and an unselfish offense.
It's a Duke team that's averaging 17 assists a game, third best in the ACC. Parker is back on the floor now for the Blue Devils. Hood, little leaner, and yep. It's brought down by Steidel.
For a score, you can get that anytime. That was a lot of space. But again, you see Vermont trying to pack it in on the defense. And their goal is to check and make them shoot contested jumpers. But that extra pass has them shooting open jumpers.
Hood pulls down the miss from Harold. Rashid Suleiman had Cook for a moment.
Suleiman is one player we want to see get going. Coach Wojciechowski was saying he's still getting his feel because last year he was one of their premier perimeter ball handlers. But Jabari Parker and Hood has taken over that spot, so he's adjusting to him and his role with this team.
You would think for a team averaging 93 points a game and your starters are giving you 71 points a game, that there's enough shots to go around, especially at this tempo for Duke. Another one for Rugg. He's got a dozen now, nearing his season average of 15. Right? I mean, it's not like we're watching Wisconsin here and there's only so many shots. I mean, this is, all due respect to Bo Ryan, this is a Duke team that is willing to run, and yeah, everybody seemingly has a green light.
Well, you're playing to your strength. Jabari can play off the ball, the extra pass. Watch that right there.
Cook spins in the lane and finishes.
Right now, they've been effective. They're carving up Vermont's defense, but Vermont's not laying down for them. It's just you've got skilled guys on the perimeters that's able to make one-on-one plays.
Jimmy Ogile with his first personal foul.
Watch the ball movement, side to side, four passes, and then a wonderful one-on-one finish.
Hector Harold at the free throw line now. He wasn't sure where Cook went or where he ended up after that spin move. 5 points and five dimes for Cook here in the first half.
If I'm Vermont, I'm still scoring points as well. You look at them, they'll look like they'll probably get 40 points in this half. That's heading towards an 80-point game. So this is a high-scoring game. The challenge for them is to get closer to those jump shooters and defend and play gap defense. So you got to contest the shot and you got to play gap defense. But that's going to be hard because Duke is exceptional when they're playing 15 feet and in.
Adrian, this is a Vermont team that averages only 63 points a game. And as you mentioned, they're going to get to 40 in the first half. Foul inside will go against Apfel, his second. The NIT season tip-off continues our journey to the tourney. Drexel in Arizona will go 7 o'clock on ESPNU, and then Duke follows against Alabama 9:30 on ESPN2 on Wednesday. Championship game, part of ESPN's journey to the tourney, presented by Sonic. A season-long spotlight on games that will impact the tournament.
TJ McConnell, transfer from Duquesne, that's running the point guard position now to Arizona, will be a huge addition to him.
Jefferson misses them both.
Shoots it flat. You've got to put some air on it, put some arc on it. The higher the arc, the better your percentage of making it. Soften it up.
He has struggled from the line all season. Carissimo gets by Cook. Went to the left. What a shot by Sandro Carissimo.
That play there was from scouting them from the East Carolina game, saying if we can get past their penetration, and their coach was saying, Coach Becker was saying, we've got to win our one-on-one matchup. He won that one-on-one matchup on that drive. Coming down, beating the Duke pressure, under control. There's not really shot blocking out there. Plumlee's not there this year. Kelly is not there this year. So you can get shots at the rim if you can break down their penetration.
But on the other end, Carissimo just picked up his third personal. And so he'll have to take a seat with 6 points. How important is the point guard position to Vermont? They've only had 6 starting point guards since 1988.
No one and duns? Wow.
Cook's got another free throw coming his way. When you have point guards that you can
rely on.
Oh, for year after year, he started 91 consecutive games.
Give him the car keys. That's what it is. You're trusting them with the car keys. They set the defense. They're the coach on the floor. What was that? Is that six? Only six since 88?
Six since 88.
It's impressive.
You've had 6 different cars since 88.
None of them had an 8-track in it, though. All of them didn't have the 8-track, baby.
Vocal always looking to pass for good looks.
You want to attack. If you got a good shot, you've got to attack Duke.
Plenty of time on the shot clock. It's only now at five. They had the back cut there. It's taken away by Duke. Turnover number four for Vermont.
Had rabbit ears on that play. You're listening to the crowd counting down. And that was a foul. That should be three shots for Suleiman.
Here comes Vokel. Harold passed on the three, and he gets the leaner to go. He's got eight. You mentioned the 40-point plateau. Vermont is past it with Gordon at Arizona. There's still work to be done for Jabari Parker, and the key set, he said, is that he wants to be coached. He has an open mind. He's a willing student, and that's one of the reasons he said he chose Duke. Last possession of the half for the Blue Devils. Cook wants Dawkins. Six on the clock. Rodney Hood will pull. Parker had a hand on it, and he'll get whistled for the foul. Got stuck inside on Vokel, and that's the first on Jabari Parker.
Yeah, that was a cheap foul by Jabari, but you're right where Coach was saying he wants to be coached. And Coach Wojciechowski said he's fully unpacked his bags, so he's living in the moment. He's enjoying college. He's enjoying being comfortable where he is, and it's refreshing to see, because by the time you're in the 10th grade, your family and friends are telling you that you can play in the NBA.
None of my family and friends tell me that.
I use that "you" too loosely. I should have said "use."
Vokel's got another one coming his way. There's only 7/10 of a second remaining.
Guys like you, Jabari.
4-4 Vokel. Duke gets it to Cook well after the buzzer. Duke's largest lead was 15. They've allowed 43 points and a half, the most points given up in a half this season for the Blue Devils. But they lead 51-43. Now to the studio of Matt Schick and Dino Gaudio for the SportsCenter U Halftime Report.
They've withstood the drought, shooting 66%, their best shooting performance of the season thus far.
And it's the best half against Duke since Kansas took control of that game with a great second half shooting the basketball.
Well, how about Andre Dawkins, a young man you're really happy for, knocking down the shot, senior leadership, excellent first half.
Cannon Roosin has been held scoreless in this game, and Sandro Carissimo has battled foul trouble. He finds Rugg out to Roosin. And now a three from Atfeld. And a foul inside will go against Vermont. And that will be the second on Clancy Rugg. We gave you the numbers on Roosin in the first half. They are 9-1 last year when he scored 10 points or more. They're a 500 team when he doesn't make it to double figures, and he's scoreless through a half.
Well, Coach knows their team. Coach Becker said, we're getting good shots. We just got to make them. On that possession, that was a good shot.
Jabari Parker, mid-range game. He's got that, too.
You look at this young man, and there's so much to love about him, but one thing you appreciate about him is the poise. He plays through the expectation. He plays through the talking heads in the media. As Coach K said, you talking heads. I think he was talking about you.
He plays through the comparisons to Grant Hill. Foul inside will go against Duke, and Emil Jefferson his second, and that'll put Appel on the line.
Now, Coach won't be happy. Neither coach will be happy about this. Again, penetration way too easy. When you get points in the paint like they had in the first half, 30 points, eventually something's going to give. It's usually foul trouble for your big guys.
Luke Appeld is at his season average of 10 a game. This is where Jabari Parker can take over. He's the break for Rodney Hood. And Parker, playing aggressively, knocks it out of bounds. You've seen his coast-to-coast dunk against East Carolina. It was a one-possession game when he came up with a block, took it the length of the floor, and threw down the dunk. He seems to know when his team needs him the most, and a hand check out front will be the second on Quinn Cook.
Sense in the moment. Again, Vermont's very attached to this game. An eight-point game. If you're shooting three-pointers, that's only three possessions. But you look at that. Look at how impressive that is. The winningest program just behind UConn in the Northeast in the last 10 years. You've got to have talent, as Red Auerbach says, and that screwed up. So he's had talent, and he hadn't screwed it up. But you got to know when to hug and know when to bug.
A little birdie in East Lansing tells me something interesting, though, that At Michigan State, they still use the old school clipboard, not that fancy one that looks like the actual floor. And the reason is because Coach Izzo breaks too many of the expensive ones, so they have to stick with the very basic model.
I'll go with that. But there's a method to the madness, trying to go to the Final Four again.
Carissimo trying to go to the left hand again. It's paid off for him already once today, but it falls off the rim, and his counterpart, Quinn Cook, will set the offense for Duke.
This has been a blistering pace. Duke is on pace to score 100 points. Vermont on pace to score over 90 points. Keep an eye on if they can keep this pace up without fouling and fatiguing. When you start fouling and fatiguing, you start creating turnovers. There were only four turnovers by Vermont in the first half, two by Duke. So it wasn't a high turnover game in the first half.
Vermont's a team that doesn't typically turn it over, but they haven't played at this pace all season.
Well, you've got to continue. They make you play at their pace, so you've got to continue to score baskets. But it hadn't been hard. They look like they always play at this pace. Too easy.
And the feed for the baseline jam to Clancy Rugg. It's an 8-point game. Rugg's got 14.
How can a veteran team come in and get 47 points and still be competitive? One, they're not afraid. Two, they're playing with tremendous poise, and they're getting what they want off the extra pass.
Parker had a hand on it. It's Jefferson instead, and Emil Jefferson has his first field goal. Lead back to 10 for Duke. Volkel only averages 3 field goal attempts a game.
If he was a scorer, he'd be an all-conference performer because he's getting what he wants off the dribble.
Rugg all the way in against Parker, and he takes it home. The senior from Burlington High School is having a game. He's got 16.
What team can make a stop and go on a run and get separation in this game? Can Vermont make a stop and close this thing and get themselves a lead? And can Duke get a stop? Offensively, it hadn't been a problem. Now defensively, can they get a stop and get separation?
That entry pass turns it over. Jefferson tried to find Parker on the other side. Vermont found the rim.
Look at that extra pass, head up, unselfish. Rugg was a double-figure scorer, 12 points in the first half. And then the shot fake coming out, 6'8". He's hard to guard, even for Hood, who's pretty quick himself.
Locale gives it right back. Carissimo finds at foul. And that one will go against Vermont. It's the third on Luke Appel, the senior out of Chattanooga, Tennessee.
Good ball movement. Beating him to a spot. That's a good call. You're not seeing as many charges this year, but Josh Hairston is committed to getting to that charge. He was able to take that one. But if I'm watching Vermont, I'm liking what I'm seeing on the offensive end. Offense hasn't been a problem sharing the basketball, shooting the percentage. It's right here trying to guard this dribble penetration for him.
Rodney Hood, the lefty, went hard, and he came down on his right arm. And he is holding that elbow after losing to Albany in the title game of the America East Tournament. Made it to the America East Championship game for the 8th time in 11 years. Head coach John Becker.
His team has represented themselves very well in this game. Come out here, their keys were to transition defense. They've been competitive, and they had to win their one-on-one matchup offensively. They've done that on the offensive end.
Another free throw for Hood, who went down hard on his right elbow. But seemingly fine as he stays in the game.
Looks like Duke is trying to be more frisky, more attentive on the defensive end, but those driving gaps have given them problems.
That last foul was committed by Clancy Rugg, who's got a team-high 16 points, but also 3 fouls. Here is Parker! Timeout, Vermont. Jabari Parker with the steal and the stuff for Duke.
You can see it coming. The defense picked up, pushed up, and then Jabari Parker gets the crowd going. I like this timeout by Coach Becker. He doesn't want the Cameron Crazies to be louder than what they already are. Is this a theme for him this year or what? A runaway freight train finishing at the rim.
Preseason first team All-America, according to Sporting News. Preseason Rookie of the Year in the ACC. Is 22 against Davidson, or the second most in an opener by a freshman under Mike Krzyzewski. And you consider all the Burger Boys that they've had here, the McDonald's All-Americas, the freshman sensations that have worn a Duke uniform. And this guy is, with his production, putting himself in a class all by himself. And that is a scary comparison to make to all the greats who have worn this uniform.
Well, he's a distinctive young man. He's as good as the hype so far. He's been producing.
But he got beat on the baseline that time by Hector Herald. Mike Krzyzewski said that's one thing he needs to work on, his post defense.
Well, Coach K will look at this film and say his unit, all five of them on the floor, have got to be more attentive to detail on the defensive end in this game.
Rashid Suleiman passed up the three.
Suleiman's got to shoot that one. He's a threat. He's got to look for his offense.
Dangerous pass to Hairston, and they'll get Hector Herald for his first personal. It's the most thorough college football show on television, with in-depth analysis, discussion of the standings, impact of upcoming games, and interviews with football coaches and players. You won't want to go anywhere else. BCS Countdown, presented by Discover Card, tonight at 8:30 on ESPN, then at 9 on ESPNU. Both shows also live on Watch ESPN. Duke has a chance to play in a BCS bowl. They need to knock off North Carolina and Chapel Hill next week. Then they'll get Florida State in the ACC title game. What a tremendous run for David Cutcliffe and his Blue Devils. Quinn Cook. Too strong. We're at Cameron Indoor Stadium. You know, Eddie Cameron was once a football coach at Duke. He beat Alabama in the 1945 Sugar Bowl.
History there. I appreciate that history.
Of course, he was also the basketball coach, but here's where they stand in the Coastal Division. Duke controls its destiny with a 5-2 conference mark, sitting at 9 wins for the Blue Devils. What an amazing season. When David Cutcliffe came here to interview at Duke, he requested an audience with Mike Krzyzewski. Two longtime coaches sat down, talked about the entire athletics department and how everything works here. And it was only then that Cutcliffe decided that this would be the right spot for him.
I remember Coach K back in the beginning. He was came in with Jimmy V, Coach Valvano, back in 1980, I believe. And now to see him many, many years later, and he's still relevant. Most people rust out before they wear out, and he's neither no rust or no wear out. He's still current. That's why I always love to ask him, Coach, tell me about what you're curious about with this game. And he loves living in his players' moments.
He's curious if they can get rebounds or if they can stop fouling. That last one was on Josh Hairston.
There comes a point in the game when you know what your opponent is. You know if your opponent is better than you. You know if the opponent is a more superior athlete. And for Vermont, they're comfortable with running this offense because they believe they can get shots just like that possession or get to the free throw line.
This is the spot in the game where East Carolina made a run last Tuesday. Duke let them hang around and hang around. And what was once an 18-point lead, taken down to just one. Jabari Parker took over then, and this time he turns it over. He wasn't on the same page with Dawkins. Last time down, Kurt Steidel was able to throw one in.
Look at the open separation, a well-run play. You like that soft touch, shooter's touch.
Vermont is shooting 71% this half, 68% from the floor in this game. They came in shooting less than 40%, 304th in the nation. But they came to this building and they found their shooting touch. They've had the wins for some time, but the ball just wasn't finding the net in the first five games.
Coach K said it's something about teams that don't shoot well and come in here and raise their game. He was aware of that. They've been able to withstand the run of Vermont. They have the better athletes. They have the pros on their team. You've got Rodney Hood, that's a pro talent, and of course Jabari Parker, and that's what's been the difference. And Andre Dawkins has been lights out out coming off that bench.
Foul trouble for Vermont, including Carissimo. He's got three. He breaks down Dawkins. Good help from Hairston. Inside Rugg to the left. And the follow jam from Hector Herald. We have a game at Cameron. It's a six-point Duke lead.
You and I called the Florida Gulf Coast game last year. We said Florida Gulf Coast is going to be a problem to deal with. And Vermont has represented themselves very well in this game. They're going to be a problem in this game and in their conference this season.
Parker lost the basketball again. Another turnover. Last couple of possessions for the freshman. Harold gave it up.
Where's the defense? Poor closeout. Poor closeout.
Great feed. And it rolls home for Clancy Rugg. He's got 18. It's a four-point game. Duke coaches know when a team like Vermont comes in or East Carolina, they got nothing to lose, and at some point they're playing with house money. Well, Vermont's 8-0 run is all house money for the Catamounts.
Well, the crowd has come. This is a huge basket if he can hit that one. Huge shot.
Vermont's got it. Carissimo.
Playing with confidence. Vermont's playing with confidence. You can see their body language. They're relaxed. The Cameron Crazies are trying to encourage their team on because they know they're in for a game right now.
They won 21 last year. They've scored 10 straight tonight. It's a one-possession game. 14 for Hector Herald.
Look at the body language for Vermont. Basketball is a game of enthusiasm, and the big bodies can get going by the time you get the conference play.
Jabari Parker and Rodney Hood combined to average 44 points a game, one of only seven teams in the nation with two players averaging more than 20. They're doing their part thus far tonight, but nobody's doing their part in the defensive end for Duke.
Yeah, scoring won't be a problem for you. You have 61 points. You still have 11 minutes to go in the second half. Scoring hadn't been a problem. It's been about the defense.
Rodney Hood, and he draws a foul on Hector Herald. It's a second. A lot of highlights for Vermont in the second half. They have come out, shared the basketball, and they're just torching the Nets.
Look at the extra pass, the high percentage shots. They were only shooting less than 40% in this game. They've met the challenge so far, down by two on the road. They have been 8-for-11, outstanding in the second half.
Rodney Hood to the free throw line. Duke has won 105 consecutive non-conference home games. February 2nd of 2000, St. John's left with an 83-82 victory. 2000 was the last time a non-conference opponent got a win here.
Well, you look at Duke offensively, they can't play any better. They're shooting the ball, they're getting their shots that they want. But the story for both teams is stopping each other's offense.
Harold got a bump. He'll go to the line, and Hairston bumped his head on the hardwood. Hector Herald will have a chance for a three-point play, and Hairston is slow to his feet. It's his fourth personal foul, but maybe much more than that. Mike Krzyzewski wanted to get Jabari Parker a breather, and he has to re-enter for Josh Hairston. Pardon me, that's a foul, Rodney Hood. Instead, it's Hood's second.
Big guys taking one for the team, doing the dirty work. Committed to taking charges, committed to guarding the best interior defender.
He actually went into Suleiman's knee on the way down, the back of his head. So Hairston leaves with three fouls, not four. And Harold, a career high 17 points now. The Pepperdine transfer is feeling the flow at Cameron. It's a one-point game.
You got yourself a game.
Jabari Parker fouled from behind by Harold. But it's one of the things that will be so tough for opponents is getting mismatched against Jabari Parker.
Well, wherever he is, we were asking about his dynamic duel, Coach K's dynamic duel, and he said Hood sees the game from a wing player. Jabari Parker sees the game as a basketball player. Wherever he is, he's going to try to make a positive play.
Andre Dawkins sees jump shots. He's got 16 now. Duke's lead extended to 4.
Can Vermont make an answer?
There it is! Carissimo again. His first in the second half, and it's a 2-point game again.
Playing with a little flavor. You can see a little swagger from Carissimo. Coming down confident. He's not deterred by the pressure that Cook is trying to put on him. Good patience by Duke.
Parker steps back, drills it right in Hector Herald's face.
Yeah, that was excellent defense. Excellent defense, big time shot.
Will anybody play defense in the second half? That was a confident jumper from Carissimo, the senior.
Actually, both teams have been trying. They've just been shooting each other's lights out.
Duke 60% from the floor in the second half. It's a first and Steidl, the personal foul.
Isolation, the step back, the poise, good defense. You want to shoot a contested jumper, but you've got a pro out there on the floor. When I'm watching a college game, who's got a difference maker? He's a difference maker, and he can get his in the flow of the offense.
Jabari Parker looks a little bit winded here as he goes to the free throw line.
You always get that second window when it's time to score baskets. Won't be that tired.
Remember, foot injury, Simeon in Chicago cost him 5 months of activity. He put on 35 pounds going into his senior year of high school, and he's worked hard to shed that weight. Left it short, though. Lead is 5.
The Catamounts have gotten penetration off the high screen and roll. This play right here, playing in the middle of the floor.
Vocal won't shoot it. He rarely does.
And you don't want to hesitate. You don't want to give Duke's defense confidence.
Carissimo with a burst, and he finishes again. That, I think, as much of anything, is a key look into the new rule emphasis. If you've got a great point guard, he can get to the rack.
Absolutely. You look at UConn and Shabazz Napier. He's having a big-time year because you can't touch him. Freedom of movement.
You're going to need a new rule to slow down Jabari Parker. He's got 18. Duke's lead back to 5.
This has been a key guy right here. Carissimo controlling the game, probing the defense, undeterred. You can't speed him up. And Vermont is making the extra pass.
Dawkins left his man. We get a jump ball, and the Vermont bench is beside itself. John Becker's wondering about the call. 7th turnover for Vermont. That's Carissimo getting it done.
Against a good defender in Quinn Cook. And then the penetration again. Can't cut off everything. This has been a mirror image of each other.
That was called a jump ball.
Let him play. Let him play.
Quinn Cook from deep. Those are some of the shots that Quinn Cook took in the second half against East Carolina that helped the Pirates get back in the game. Look at this feed. Hector Herald has a triple. His first to season-high 20. 2-point game.
If you're scouting against Duke, you're going to watch the East Carolina game, and you're going to watch the Vermont game to see how you can try to get offense and easy shot opportunities against a quick defense. They've been getting the shots they want with that extra pass.
Extra pass to Dawkins in the corner. Loose ball taken out of there by Sandro Carissimo. 4-year starter at point guard looking for his biggest win as a Catamount, and he draws a foul from Tyler Thornton. It's a 3rd on Thornton. These Catamounts playing with confidence in the second half.
Watch the poise, the flavor, the extra pass. What do? You knock it down when you're on the road.
Syracuse, the newest member of the ACC, number 20, Baylor, will take on Chaminade. And Dayton and Gonzaga meet at midnight on Tuesday. Sandro Carissimo has a 1-on-1. He has 11 points.
This game looks like 10 guys that said, we'll meet you at 7 o'clock in the evening. Let's have a street ball game. And I say that as a compliment of both teams losing themselves in the game. Their flaw has been the inability to stop each other defensively. But offensively, sharing the ball, making the extra pass, both teams have been exceptional on that on the offensive end.
We were last tied when it was 6-all. Who will answer for Duke?
Good ball movement. Good patience.
Hood has Cook on the wing. Quinn Cook penetrates. Floats one up off the glass. Mismatch. Parker on Carissimo.
Rusin has not forced his offense. He and Vocal have not forced their offense. They've allowed scoring to come off the best pass, the best option.
This is Hector Herald, and that's another three. He is 6 of 6 for 15 points in the second half. He's pulling a Jimmy Barron here tonight.
You remember that one. There you go.
November of 08, Barron in Rhode Island nearly knocked off Duke.
Put on the show.
He had 8 threes in that one. Loose ball. Vermont basketball. It's a 1-point Vermont lead thanks to Hector Herald.
Preseason number one in American East. Not intimidated. 4 key players are out. But look at this young man scoring on the drive, the putback, and then the confidence. He's going to shoot the three, and then he's going to tell you, I'm going to give you a three.
He left Malibu for Burlington. Who goes from Pepperdine to Vermont? Hector Herald does. Carissimo's got a huge one. Vermont's playing out of their minds here tonight. It's a 3-point lead. 74% shooting in the second half. They came in shooting less than 40%. I'd say the lid has been lifted for the Catamounts.
Coach K has his 5 best offensive players out on the floor right now.
Jabari Parker. 20 for the freshman.
This young man senses the moment.
All right, 5 best offensive players. Do they have 5 best defensive players?
We'll see, because Vermont has the lead, and they're playing with a swagger right now.
Nearly turned it over. Carissimo, a senior from Sleepy Hollow, New York.
Got time on the shot clock. Good patience for Vermont.
Vocal rarely shoots, only 3 attempts a game. 3 ball. Tipped up and in! It's Rugg again. He's got 20.
Both teams are looking at a mirror image of each other. Scoring is coming from the 3-point shot, the foul line, and the putbacks.
And a steal by Vocal. Numbers for Vermont. Carissimo. And an offensive rebound again for the Catamounts.
I like that shot. In the flow, he's been feeling it, and you have to continue to attack Duke. You can't be hesitant against them. Let's see if they get something inside the paint again. They've been getting mileage once they've been 15 feet in.
Hector Herald. Another one off the glass for Vermont. Hood commits a foul, his 3rd.
Duke has had a challenge on the penetration. There's a shot here, but then the putback, the effort, the extra effort. They're feeling it. The penetration has been breaking down the defense. Jabari Parker has to come over, and then his guy gets the putback. 5 guys have to move as one. They're in for a game. This Vermont has staying power, Tom.
Clancy Rugg, 2009 Mr. Basketball in the state of Vermont. Not exactly the same as Mr. Basketball from Illinois. Yet Rugg and Parker even at 20 points apiece.
Well, you played a good game. Don't let your wrist get tight. You got to continue to play and attack. Both teams, you have to continue to attack.
Parker on the baseline. Great body control. And they're going to say that was a hack on Clancy Rugg. His 4th personal.
And
reference that Jimmy Barron game. Rhode Island came in here in 2008 and just missed upsetting Duke. 82-79 was the final. After that game, Mike Krzyzewski said this was a February game played in November, and that's what Duke's getting tonight, a high-intensity game against a non-conference opponent.
Now, does Vermont believe in the next 426 that they can win this game by continuing to run their offense with confidence and shooting it with confidence? Because Duke is going to make their run at them. But does Vermont believe they can come down and execute a good offense and solid defense in the money?
Why stop what you're doing?
You want to continue to attack. Carissimo has been fantastic. I like this timeout. Settle them down. Try to get a good play coming out of a timeout.
Remember, Vermont knocked off Syracuse in the NCAA tournament, a 14 seed upsetting a 3 seed. Come on tonight. Give me. And how about this? At the timeout, Sandro Carissimo just changed shoes.
Yeah, he was slipping twice.
Yeah, he pulled on a new pair of sneakers. Yeah. That's great use of a timeout to be efficient enough to change your sneakers.
Now, you got time on the shot clock, 10 seconds to get a good possession. He's still falling.
Five. Vocal gives it up. Rusin fires. He was fouled shooting a desperation three. It's a fourth on Tyler Thornton. Oh, my. A major defensive mistake by Thornton and Duke. This was the only chance Vermont had, and Thornton couldn't slam on the brakes. Lid hasn't just been lifted. It's been ripped off and thrown out in the alley.
Well, you look at Duke, and Duke's numbers are not as strong as Vermont, but both coaches offensively are saying the same thing on the defensive end. Stop penetration, hold them to one and done. Five guys move as one. Try to collect the rebound and contest the shot.
Cannon Rusin has another one coming his way. John Becker spent 3 years as an assistant at Vermont, 2 years as the operations director under Mike Lonergan. One more for Rusin, and he's 0 for 2 now.
Well, you got to be mentally tough in his face. You got to be confident, young man. Play too well of the game.
From Marist makes one of three. Free throws have been key. All the key lead changes have come on free throws here late in this game.
You can ask North Carolina about free throws against Belmont.
Dawkins too strong. Rusin had it, and we get a foul underneath on Hector Herold. He checked Hood. That is number 4 on Herold, who's got a game-high 23. How about North Carolina today? Big win against Louisville.
Yeah,
huge victory for Roy Williams.
I was very surprised. I thought Louisville would run them out because of the display of North Carolina, but that was a galvanizing performance. But also for Louisville, they've got to get out of themselves and stop drinking the Kool-Aid, the national championship Kool-Aid. I didn't like what I saw from them as a team.
Rodney Hood and Jabari Parker, top scoring duo in the ACC, have combined for 42. Hood makes it 43 and now ties the game at 79.
Tom.
Free throws again.
Who's going to be the first team to blink? Vermont. They've got to play through this noise, this atmosphere. Can they keep their poise, run a high screen and roll, and be tough when they go to the basket?
360th consecutive sellout of Cameron Indoor. Vocal leads him in assist, and he finds Rusin on the back cut.
We have seen everything from Vermont. The back door, the high screen and roll, the putback dunk, the transition, the free throws. They have had their offensive repertoire.
Jabari Parker somehow threw it down. We've talked about his touch. We've talked about his versatility. How about the hands on this one above the rim to tie it at 81?
Best seat in the house, folks. We've got the best seat in the house. We're seeing the slam dunks. We're seeing the strategy. Watch this backdoor cut right there. Beats Jabari Parker, but he comes back a short memory. Jabari comes back with a short memory. Throw it up there. I've got you. strong finish.
Both put it in and took it off the rim, all on the same play. He's over 20 again for the sixth consecutive game. Second best streak to open a season in Duke history.
To the legend Art Haman way back in the day.
And Haman did it in 10 straight.
Duke is still playing a man-to-man. Vermont's done a good job when it comes at the high screen and roll. They let the big guys set.
No reason to guard Vocal. He doesn't shoot. This is Carissimo now.
One timeout for both teams, so you want to remember that.
Set back on Hood, and Quinn Cook has it. Vermont's in the middle of a 7-game, 15-day road trip. I don't know if they'll have the legs for the last 2:30.
Keep an eye on Jabari Parker. He's been able to get it off the glass. A missed shot has been his best friend.
Quick three. Parker with the follow. Yes, sir. You got it.
I was watching him the entire time. They had a double team, but it wasn't a strong block out on him.
First lead for Duke since it was 73-71 with 7:26 to play. Vocal decides to take it to the rack. His first bucket in the second half, tied at 83.
Now Thornton is not. Thornton won't beat you with the three-point shot, though he had a history of hitting big shots. His concentration goes up. But you've got to guard and rebound.
Whoa! Ice cold Quinn Cook! Your DeMantha guy steps up big.
Well, you got 10 ballers out here on both teams. Both teams are going toe-to-toe in this.
Vocal to Carissimo. Duke trying to hold on. Trying to make it a two-possession game.
Duke will run some clock down. We got time on the shot clock. Again, keep an eye on Quinn Cook. If he's open, he'll shoot it. But then Jabari Parker down low has been active.
10 on the clock. Cook looking for Parker. Can't find him. Four. Three ball. And a foul inside will go against Rodney Hood. That is his fourth personal foul. Under a minute to go. Three-point game in Vermont shooting free throws.
I was watching this play the entire time. There's going to be a double team, but it's got to be strong. He's got an effort inside. He has a knack for finding the basketball. And then how about Quinn Cook, the emotional leader? Oh, yeah, we're at home. I like the three-point shot, he's saying.
Hector Harold transfers from Pepperdine as a career-high 23. Appel returns for Vermont. Harold's got another one coming.
Mental toughness. Slow yourself down. Over the front rim. Backspin follow through. Slow yourself down.
Two-point lead for Duke.
It's about a 20-second differential with the shot clock. If there's a miss, Vermont has to get the basketball back. And if there's a drive to the basket, you've got to help him recover.
Suleiman will take it with plenty of time on the shot clock, and he draws a foul. Would you like to see more patience from Duke in the second half when they have a lead?
You would say that, but they're in the flow of the game. He had a driving lane. That's not a bad drive. Suleiman has been quiet. 2 points. He has had to make the biggest adjustment to Jabari Parker and, of course, for Rodney Hood. But he's a good free throw shooter.
And the best thing of that foul for Duke is it got Hector Harold out of the game. He fouls out with a team high 24, a new career high. And he has to take a seat. Vermont finds some offense to replace him.
Well, you asked Coach Becker, even beyond this game, what does this mean? And he said this, what I'm hoping, this will be a wake-up call. We want to compete. We want to win this basketball game. But this game here has been the lightning rod for their season. They have arrived to this season.
Rashid Suleiman at the free throw line. His first point of the game makes it a three-point lead. Thornton replaces Dawkins. Defensive-minded switch for Duke. Two-possession game as Suleiman hits them both.
Big basket. Huge basket for Suleiman, like you said, making it a two-possession game. Watch Suggs. Watch Atfield. They have scoring in the post.
Short. Carissimo with the follow. That's a point guard on the glass for Vermont. Duke needs better rebounding overall, but they really lean on their guards to get some key rebounds. That time they couldn't keep Carissimo off.
Well, missed shot under 4 minutes has been the best friend on both offenses. A follow-up by the smallest guy on the floor. Good feel for the game. Now, what they're talking about with Coach Becker, he's talking about being strong. If you have an opportunity to go for a steal, go for the steal. They're going to have to foul. They can't allow Duke to run the shot clock out. And most everybody on that floor for Duke is a good free throw shooter.
Jabari Parker only had 7 points at intermission. He's got 19 in the second half. And as you described earlier, he has a great feel for when his team needs him.
It's the moment. The breakaway steal. 17 points. The alley-oop dunk. Looks like a young Carmelo Anthony. That inside-outside flow. Wonderful demeanor. He's got the respect of his teammates. He's made it look easy, and he hasn't taken a lot of shots. He hasn't taken a bad shot this game.
Duke still has one timeout remaining. Vermont out of timeouts. Hood can run the baseline. Here comes the trap on Quinn Cook.
Got to get it over.
Cook trying to find some space. He draws the foul from Josh Elbaum. It's the first on Elbaum. And so Elbaum takes a seat. They bring Clancy Rugg back in, who's playing with four fouls.
Offense for defense. Didn't want your key inside player to pick up a foul. But for Quinn Cook, you want to make this a two-possession game. This is huge free throws for him.
Rodney Hood tried to steal a spot on the lane because Vermont doesn't have anybody on the low block. And so Volkel, the senior, who's making his 107th consecutive start, steps in. Two-point game. Next one is big for Duke. Thornton back on the floor.
For Vermont, they don't have any timeouts, so they have to get the ball up quickly, see if they can get something in transition, and then look to go for a steal or foul. Got to go quickly.
Got to get a shot off in a hurry. Carissimo in the paint. Rusin, he made it, and he was fouled. A chance to tie it. Unbelievable. Candon Rusin with his first three of the game, and he'll go to the line.
Coach K said he doesn't get up much during the game. Good call. He slipped down, but he's got to let the defender come down. We don't see it in this shot. Suleiman trips, falls over him.
Rusin missed two of three free throws moments ago. This one would tie it. 10 seconds remain.
See if he slows himself down on this one and watch the follow through on this free throw.
We are tied at 90. The officials are going to the replay booth, and here's what they're going to look at. They want to make sure that was a three from Rusin. Now, the way the ACC does replays, our television truck is no longer involved in the replays.
Yeah, but you want to make a quick call and get back to the flow of the game. It's definitely a three-point shot.
Well, Jamie,
come on,
look,
guys, get back to the flow of the game.
I thought that's what he was doing. They never looked at it.
Yeah, that's a three-point shot all day long.
Maybe they went over for a timing issue.
Well, it's been a well-called game, but you still want to keep the suspense and the anticipation of the game.
Let the kids play.
Let the kids play. Make the call. Let's go.
Does Duke have a game winner, or do we get free basketball?
If you're Duke, you want to attack the basket.
It's Rodney Hood. All the way. And they get Hood to the free throw line as Rugg fouls out. We're pretty far away from the action here at Duke, but that looked like it was all ball from here.
No problem, because with 5 seconds left, Rodney's going to a strong hand. He's a lefty. Got no problem with the call. Catamount fans will say, nah, he missed the call on that one. However, with 5 seconds left, they sure get the ball back and get a good shot. And because it's not a three-point differential in this possession, they should be able, Duke will not want to foul him on that possession when they get the ball.
Rodney Hood was 12 of 12 from the free throw line against East Carolina. He is a perfect 6 of 6 tonight. Rugg with a monster night. He sits with 20.
Tom, we saw very good Florida golf coach last year, and I'm going to say, hey, as a fan, let's go overtime. We're both overtime. I'm riding with you anyway.
I got nowhere to go.
Let's go overtime. How about that one?
One more coming for Rodney Hood.
Make sure for the green, you got to block out. Now, you got time now. You've got time, and Duke will not want to foul. See if they can get, there's no timeouts, so you've got to drive the length of the floor.
Vermont out of timeouts. Carissimo lost a handle with 2 seconds. Got to get it up, and Vermont doesn't get a shot off.
No
Duke is able to stop Vermont. The Catamounts couldn't get it off quickly enough. Hood's free throw is the difference.
Time and score, you gotta have it in your head. Brewson's gotta shoot it, a catch and shoot. Good call, heartbreaking loss. Wow, way to represent yourself. 90 points, lose by one, but big time game.
Duke improves to 5-1 for Vermont. It's what could have been. And Duke's non-conference home win streak goes to 106 consecutive games. It'll take a while for Vermont to leave the gym after a gutsy effort here. Our final score, Duke 91, Vermont 90. Coming up next, ESPNU All Access, Louisiana Lafayette football. For more, log on to ESPN.com. So long from Durham. Another thriller at Cameron, and Duke goes